I was concerned last week when the original proposal was put to me with regarding the changes in the amount of time available, and I reviewed the situation in the context of the advice that I had got. And it emerges that while the school population increased last year by 1.3% in population terms, the increase in the number of students qualifying for special resources and special needs increased by 12%. Now, this is an extraordinary surge, and it has to be investigated as to why. But you should take that observation in the context of what I have been advised formally by the NCSE, which is that the current model of allocation of resources based on certificates received in relation to learning difficulties or otherwise that children would have, that model is seriously flawed as far as the NCSE is concerned, and that it should be replaced with a different model. From the time that we came into government, the Labour Party in particular, myself as Minister for Education, has been concerned to protect and ring-fence the resources that we allocate to special needs education. It was 1.3 billion euros when we came into government, and it is 1.3 billion today after three budgets. And the number of teachers and SNAs is exactly the same. 10,575 SNAs and approximately 10,000 special teachers and resource teachers. But we will and we have ring-fenced the amount of resources that we have, but we have to look at the way in which those resources are deployed, and we also have to look at the outcomes that those resources achieve. They're designed to help young children to improve their learning outcomes and their learning abilities.
What about the parent who wrote to Minister of State Janet Sullivan, who has a son with Asperger's who's 9 years old and really needs this? She has seen that his reduction reduced by 25%. Is that still in place?
It's not still in place. The status quo of last year will be maintained into the next year.
And after that?
Well, we'll have to look at a new model. We'll have to see. We'll have to see how we can, in fact, use this vast amount of resources. I mean, the amount of money we're spending in education, 1.3 billion, is virtually the same amount of money that we're spending in higher education in total. It is a vast resource when you look at it. What we have to make sure is that we get very good positive outcomes. And that's what the special group chaired by Eamon Stack is going to do for me.
How have you managed to do this? If there is going to be no 10% cut this year, how have you managed to do this?
In the past, we made an allocation based on the applications that came in March, and we held back a reserve for late comers and the like. The surge of 12% now probably has brought forward cases that wouldn't otherwise emerge. And I had a reserve of 500 teachers available to come in and meet that as a contingency. I'm now going to deploy them, that 500, this year, starting, it will usually be in October, but in the normal way, deployed in the normal way. But there are budgetary implications about this. I'm increasing part of the spend to meet this surge of 12%, and the extra resources that I'm going to have to find will be in the context of the budget discussions that will take place in the autumn. But to give you an idea of the scale of the kind, and I have to find those resources within my own budget. That is a big challenge, but we're not discussing that today.
What would you say to parents who've gone through an awful lot of anguish since this was announced on Wednesday?
I regret that they have gone through anguish. We are listening to what they have said. We're listening to the NCSE, and parents are represented on the NCSE. We've heard what people have said. The Cabinet Subcommittee yesterday discussed this at great length, and we have decided to bring forward the proposals to look at a new model of allocation on the one hand, and to deploy the 500 pupils this year so that there will be no change next year in the time allocation.
Is this change as a result of pressure from backbenchers and other...
Colleagues in the Parliamentary Labour Party were very concerned. Parents had contacted them. The INTO had issued a very strong condemnatory statement last week. I think that caught a lot of attention from a lot of people, and a lot of fears and concerns were then raised. And I've listened to those. I also listened to what the NCSE was saying to us, which was, look, the model you have is not working. It's not getting into the right places and in the right way. And there's sufficient evidence to indicate that schools located in better off areas seem to get a larger allocation of special resources than schools in disadvantaged areas.
Are you personally embarrassed about this finally?
I'm not. I'm not the slightest bit embarrassed. Making decisions is what government has to do. And fine-tuning those decisions and making sure that you get the right advice is what we are trying to do. The surge of 12% in the increase is really something that probably we should have reacted to it a little bit quicker. But when we started to probe into it, I realised that this is wrong. There's something weird here.
But what do you say? I mean, this is for children with hearing impairments, visual impairments, Asperger's, autism. Are you suggesting that kids might be coming in onto the radar who actually don't have these conditions and aren't entitled to?
Well, I don't think that there's been a sudden deterioration in the health or the quality of young people in our society to the extent of 12%. But they've been getting diagnoses of one kind or another that would indicate that they're entitled to additional resources. We make resources available for special education, extra teachers for the school to deploy as they see best fit, and likewise with SNAs. But the surge in the way in which support has been allocated based on psychologists' reports and diagnosis seems to me to be totally against the pattern in population generally, and that has to be investigated and has to be looked at, and we have to find a better model, a new model, that will make sure that the massive amount of money that we're putting into disability and education is effectively and fairly allocated, and that we measure the outcomes, that we're not simply just make resources available, but we make those resources available to assist young people to improve their learning ability in whatever form, and that's what we're trying to do.
Minister, this morning in the Times you said that the Anglo tapes, he had never been aware of their existence as a Michael Noonan. Can we assume then that yourself and the rest of the Cabinet weren't aware of the existence of these tapes?
I think myself and the rest of the population weren't aware of these tapes, not to mention yourselves. And I think the tone of the conversation is really what offends most people. An awful lot of people lost money because of the Anglo debacle, and the deaths have been hoisted now onto the backs of every taxpayer in the country. To hear the discussions that have been revealed in these tapes is quite shocking.
Minister, your colleague Brendan Howland this morning said that the banking inquiry will be established by the autumn. Do you have a preference for what kind of mechanism? Would it be an Oireachtas committee? Could it be a commission of investigation? Do you have a preference as to what way it will be carried out?
We're still discussing informally ourselves what is the best way to proceed. We have to make sure that it is a robust inquiry, that it gets answers to the questions that are on everybody's lips. We want to make sure that it is effective, and I'll take advice from Brendan, who's piloted through the legislation to enable the Oireachtas to undertake that inquiry. But I think a lot of discussion has to take place before any final decision will be made.
Thanks,
and
guys.
On the special needs assistance,
yes.
Is this a U-turn in short?
No, it's not, because in fact we had the 500 contingency there anyway. When we saw the surge of 12%, we realised that something strange was happening here. We had to deal with it, so I've accelerated the response. I had already in May received a report with 28 recommendations from the NCSE. One of them was, as I said already, that the present model is not satisfactory, that a new model needs to be designed and put in place. I've accelerated that.
On the issue of resources, you're saying that this is going to cost money. How much would you estimate this would cost?
Somewhere of the order of an additional 20 million.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned that better off areas seem to be getting greater support than disadvantaged areas, so can we assume that there will be future cuts in better off areas which are better served?
There will be a reallocation, possibly. I don't anticipate what the working group recommends. But what they have said formally in the report that I got, the 28 recommendations, and what was discussed on Monday, yesterday, and I've spoken at length to Mr. Eamon Stack, who's the chairman of the NCSE, and formerly that chief inspector with the department, has said to me very clearly, the model is not satisfactory, it's not allocating resources in a fair way, and we'll have to find a new kind of model that also takes into account outcomes.
Can I clarify just for parents then, from their point of view, there will be no cuts to special needs assistant hours from September.
There was
onwards.
Never any intention to reduce special needs assistance.
Yeah,
it was frozen by Fianna Fáil at 10,575, and we've kept it at that. There was a misunderstanding a year and a half ago where we kept back 10% of the total allocation for late applications, and that was perceived as a 10% cut. Now that's been clarified. And in the total of the resource teachers, in terms of numbers, between special education teachers and resource teachers, approximately 10,000, that number has been kept and will be kept. And the total amount of money of 1.3 billion will be kept as well, out of a total budget of just under 8,000 million.
So in simple terms, from a parent's point of view, what does this mean?
Next year will be the same as this year.
And what about new parents, you know, with children coming into the system?
Well, the allocation will be the same. New people come into the system and older people qualify out of it.
But with the increase, are we still talking about a...
Well, you see, the increase in the population was 1.3% and the increase in people qualifying was 12%. That just doesn't fit.
So we're still talking about cuts.
No,
ultimately,
we're not. We're talking about an allocation. We're talking about having a resource of teachers, approximately, including SNAs, approximately 20,000, and a resource of money, 1.3 billion euro. In these difficult times, when every other government department has had to reduce expenditure, and I had to reduce expenditure, we'll face a reduction this year. But I'm not looking at, I've ring-fenced in my department the amount of money available for special needs. That's not a cut.
Okay, guys. Thank you.